Ricky, we've got some schnucks today on Boxmark.
No, schnucks.
You got your Shell's Jetta, you got your original Deluxe, and you got your original not Deluxe.
This is your basic episode here at Boxmark.
If you were the kind of fan that was like, just cook some box mac.
I don't need Instant Pots. I don't need macaroni and cheese that's from Korea that's not even macaroni and cheese in any shape, way, or form.
Schnucks appears to be a store. Privately held chain of more than 90 supermarkets in St. Louis and the Midwestern United States.
Okay, 90 isn't very many, by the way, for a supermarket. Let me just say I love the name Schnucks because it's dangerously close to many naughty words.
Like what? Shucks?
I mean, schmuck, right?
Yeah, that's not naughty. Schnucks also ran stores under the Logley supermarkets and Highlander Foods banners. Schnucks is one of the largest privately held supermarket chains in the United States and dominates the St. Louis metro grocery market. They opened in 1939. This is an old brand.
This has been around for a while, but only 90 stores?
But privately held, not public.
Okay, maybe they don't want to get any bigger. Maybe they want to be like Market Basket.
They want to stay schnuckish.
They've shown the macaroni and cheese with other foods as a side dish. This is hardly ever done, to my memory, on a macaroni and cheese box. Macaroni and cheese, peas, and a roast beef with a little gravy. On this one, green beans and some kind of lined pork product.
Maybe in the Midwest, they never consider mac and cheese to be the primary part of the meal.
And I also, of course, always like this double shelving style.
Yes.
So front and back.
You know, often with these sort of fringe or market-based macs,
yeah.
I go to Google them, either to add them to the database or get a graphic, and like there's almost no web presence. I was hoping we could look up somebody's review, perhaps. It doesn't exist.
No content like that will be in this episode whatsoever.
The only thing that showed up was Schnucks baked macaroni and cheese recipe.
Yes. I've actually run into that problem before where I Google a store brand, the thing that come up is their house-made macaroni and cheese, like somebody talking about it.
Like maybe their deli or something, yeah. There are a trillion deli macs out there.
We don't really go into deli mac territory.
But we can basically redo the show from scratch, going supermarket to supermarket doing deli macs.
The thing is, they never really exist in a box, do they?
No. It'd have to be a Junt's Cart / Box Mac combination.
Yes. I've never had a deli mac I've really been in love with. Have you?
Well, I've mentioned it before. The Sysco food service mac, they serve it at a nearby supermarket. It's very mushy.
Yeah. Well, because the pasta just mushes right away.
And you would think and normally we don't like that kind of thing on Box Mac, but something about this mac.
Well, we're going to have to try it sometime.
And I'm convinced there's a sour cream note or something like that.
Yeah. Well, a lot of with those Sysco Macs is whoever's making them will take the Sysco Mac and then add in a little something to make it their own.
Yeah, right. We have a little bit of an aspiration someday.
Yeah.
To do butter substitutes.
Butter substitutes.
And I don't mean I can't believe it's not butter or something like that. I'm talking about like instead of using
butter. Place of butter.
That use sour cream or use this alternative butter or whatever.
Another one that I'd like to do along the lines of butter is actually comparing two different types of butter and seeing how much of an effect it has on the flavor. That's one of those technical kind of episodes that people sometimes enjoy.
Because it's the sort of thing that you would never do at home.
That's right.
It's too obsessive.
Yeah, but we'll do it for you on our macaroni and cheese related program.
Sort of like Christmas is a time when you receive items that you would never buy for yourself.
Yes.
Mac is a time where we make you things you would never make for yourself.
That's right.
I'm growingly convinced a lot of store brand Macs are actually the same exact thing.
I want to find the company that actually makes all of these, because there must just be like a handful of manufacturers.
Sort of like that episode we did with the truffle and the pesto and all those.
Yeah.
They were kind of putting it out on Front Street that they were all the same.
That's right.
These, they're like, well, you know, make your own design. Maybe they even have a library of clip art. Yeah. They're like, use this Mac, use that Mac. A place like HEB, I'm convinced that they have their own Mac. Sort of like Trader Joe's.
Yep.
Because HEB is more like that.
I'm sure, though, that usually with any of those store brands, the manufacturer will make them a unique variant of macaroni and cheese, adjust a little something or other. Because even though we've had store Macs, no two are perfectly identical.
As far as we know.
As far as we've...
I mean, what if there was an episode, episode 39 and episode 62?
Yeah.
Where we actually did have the same Mac twice. You know, there was one time, by the way, we've never acknowledged it on the show.
Yeah.
Where we totally did a repeat Mac without knowing it.
What?
Yes.
That actually happened?
Deluxe.
Very good.
Love it. This Deluxe is going to be the best.
Think so?
Ooh, very nice cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yes, very nice.
One fan noticed it, too, which I was very impressed by. Ashley, we did her the HEB 3 episode.
Yep.
She showed up with an HEB Deluxe.
Yep.
We forgot that we already did that HEB Deluxe. I'm happy to report that we thought the same thing about it.
That's good. I'm glad we're somewhat consistent.
Yes. So that was like a bonus retake that we didn't acknowledge as a retake.
Yep. Just different in color of the text. We need a quarter cup of margarine or butter and a quarter cup of milk. Absolutely basic standard prep, nothing.
It's a basic standard episode. This is for those of you who crave familiarity.
Yeah. As part of a basic standard episode, don't we have to have an obligatory musical segment?
Sure. Never break the chain, chain.
I don't know the song.
Fleetwood Mac. We'll just go through the Guardians of the Galaxy 2 volume.
Did the soundtrack?
Brandon, you're a fine girl.
I know that song and I kind of like it. I don't know any words of it, though.
Okay.
So keep trying.
Fox on the run. Right away.
Never a big fan of that song.
All right.
On the virtual jukebox, pressing the next button.
It's not time to make a change. Just relax. Take it easy. You're still young.
I don't know that song at all.
It's Cat Stevens, for f***'s sake. Zach's still singing it. All the time that I cried, keeping all the things I knew inside, it's hard, but it's harder to ignore it.
This song sounds terribly sad.
It's very sad. They were right, I'd agree, but it's them they know, not me. Now there's a way, and I know that I have to go away.
Oh, this song is awfully sad.
I know. There you go.
Okay. That's a lovely musical segment by Frankie.
We hope you enjoyed this.
Still doesn't know the song.
Do I need to go to Ooga Chaka to get us there?
Yes. Ooga Chaka, Ooga, Ooga, Ooga Chaka, Ooga, Ooga.
I can't chaka, stop ooga, this ooga, feeling.
Ooga Chaka, Ooga, Ooga.
Deep
ooga,
inside ooga, of
ooga,
me.
Ooga Chaka, Ooga, Ooga,
girl,
Ooga.
Girl, you just don't ooga, realize.
Ooga Chaka, Ooga, Ooga,
what you
ooga,
do to
chaka,
me.
Ooga, Ooga, Ooga Chaka, Ooga.
When you hold me in your arms so tight, you let me. No, everything's all right. I'm hooked on a feeling. I'm high on believing that you're in love with me.
Hey, these noodles are sticking together a ton back here. They're not sticking to the pot, they're sticking to each other. I'll try this technique. People say this works. You put a wooden spoon across the top of your pot.
We've reviewed this.
Oh, so it's just another standard episode of Boxman.
Yeah.
It actually breaks the bubbles before they get to the surface and is supposed to reduce the amount of overboil. I don't know if it's really helping, though. They say a wooden spoon. You actually don't need a wooden spoon at all.
I'm getting old. I'm repeating content.
I lost my other spoon. How'd I do that?
I lost my other spoon, Frankie. I lost my second spoon.
This is a really sad song. I don't know it.
I lost my second spoon, Frankie. Where is my second spoon? I lost it on the moon, Frankie. I lost my second spoon. I lost it on the moon, Frankie. Where's my second spoon?
Shall I try? Look, it's working today, but it's probably steaming the audio right now. It's steaming you as you're editing it because the audio quality is greatly reduced.
I'm sitting there editing. I'm like, was it really worth it? What does the audience care about, the audio or the steam?
I got a new tool in the kitchen, Frankie. This is a OXO pasta tester designed specifically to test pasta.
We determined in the Korean ramen episode.
Yeah, it was actually a pretty useful
That's
tool.
Really what you wanted for the grabbing. Aaron wanted to make it seem like I had a terrible technique for grabbing the pasta,
yep.
But the truth is, there was no good technique.
I can't believe you're serving noodles with a spoon. That's a great idea.
This gadget.
No, keep trying that.
Would you like to do it? We all know that Aaron is sort of the barometer of normalcy.
Is he?
Everybody's crazy, but me.
For me.
Salt.
Bring in a scale of 1 to 10. How excited are you about these Macs?
Well, I feel like I haven't had a good deluxe in a while.
Yeah, it's been a while.
I would love to have a great deluxe discovery today. I couldn't be less interested in this. It's either going to be like medium or
it's going to be bad. Okay or bad, yeah.
When was the last time we were surprised by a dry Mac?
HEB, maybe?
Yeah.
Should we chest the noodle? Chest the noodle.
We should probably chest a few noodles.
Chest the noodle. Chest your noodle. Ah! My OXO noodle device, it went directly through one of the holes.
I was wondering about the holes. Like, what's the purpose of that?
It's supposed to be to drain away water, but it's draining away noodles. Could you squeeze that cheese?
We're doing this pre-pasta?
Yes. That's the way to do it. That's the way I always do it.
No.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. That's how I always make them. I put the cheese in, then quickly throw the pasta on.
Really?
Top. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Maybe you is a detail you never thought about or noticed before. The idea is the pan is hot, so it'll start to heat up that cheese quick.
This is an incredible social experiment, this whole show. Like, what kinds of behaviors change and then get passed off as never having changed?
It's a psychological experiment done by both of us to each other.
Very strange.
Super white cheddar, even though it's not advertised as being a white cheddar.
Little dry, needs more milk. An extremely common problem in shitty store brand Max.
What would you like to try first, Frank?
The dry.
All right. Looks okay. We had to add that extra milk. I think it looks good.
It tastes like a thick and creamy mac a little bit.
Yeah.
Like less cheese, more cream.
It's pretty weak, nice and smooth. Overall, not bad.
I suppose if you encountered a dry schnucks.
Yeah.
You could
make do.
How about elbows?
Let's do it. I haven't had an elbow mac that I've really been in love with since Cracker Barrel.
Shiny, like a deluxe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't like it?
No.
It tastes fine to me.
The cheese, it doesn't agree with me.
To me, it just seems like a regular basic deluxe.
Remember that Loretta taste? It's got like a touch of that.
Yeah, I think you're right. It's pretty subtle.
Yeah, you're right.
Now it's sitting in my mouth a minute, not super pleased about it.
I don't know how I would describe it. Probably a sourness?
Sour.
Yeah. So far, the dry was better.
It's definitely got a different cheese flavor.
A touch of the same problem, but really not bad enough to ruin it for me this time.
Yep.
Because the cheese has become nice and goopy.
Yes, it's goopy. I mixed it pretty well. It still stayed a little goopy, though.
I think I kind of like it.
Yeah.
This is good. This is
pretty
is
good cheese flavor. It's your basic deluxe on the level of the guaranteed value one.
So there you go. A regular-ass episode.
Your basic interest points, discussion, song, macaroni and cheese, all checked off.
What are you up to this Sunday? What are you going to do all day on your Sunday off?
Yeah.
Comment below.
I wonder how many people are actually eating macaroni and cheese. How many of you, like, do macaroni and cheese while this?
Yeah. And two, like, if there's, like, 1,500 people who watch this, like, what are they all doing on their Sundays?
Yeah, what do
they
do? I want to know.
If you've been watching the show for a long time, you've never commented before, now's the time. Tell me what you're doing.
Tell us.
Unless it's real seedy.
Yeah.
In which case, I don't want to hear about it.
Yeah, I don't want to hear about that either.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is.